Hello everyone. So this is our fourth session. So in this session we are going to learn about plastics. So before that, as usual, we are doing revision always. First we will just take a look of synthetic fibers characteristics. So in this previous section we have completed the advantages and disadvantages of synthetic fibers, and I hope that you have completed your homework that I have told to write the 5 advantages and disadvantages of synthetic fibers. So just listen carefully again about the characteristics, about the advantages of synthetic fibers. So they are cheaper than natural fibers, then stronger, durable for long time. They just dried up in less time as they absorb very little water. They are very easy to maintain and wash. They are wrinkle resistant, lightweight. They have very smooth texture and are not attacked by moths. So these all about advantages. Then we have learned about the disadvantages of synthetic fibers, that they are melt on heating. So if we are wearing synthetic fibers and they started to melt, so that can stick to our body and causes severe burn. Next, we have learned about another disadvantages, that is the synthetic fibers are not suitable for wearing during hot summer, that we feel very hot and uncomfortable. Next, we have learned that they are not biodegradable, and because of that they can cause a pollution, that is a soil pollution. And the last disadvantage is catch fire easily, means the synthetic fibers catch the fire easily. Okay, now we will start our new point, that is plastic. So before that, just look at your surrounding and just observe that how many things are made up of plastic. Can you tell me how many things are there, or which things are there that made up of plastic? The pen that you are taking, that is also made up of plastic. Your water bottle. Okay, many things are there that made up of plastic. That is table, chair, bucket, your toys, some glass. Many things are there that made up of plastic, and due to the low cost, it is very easy to manufacture. The plastics are used in a multiple product. So first we will learn about the arrangement of plastic. Okay, so plastics, some plastics are there that are synthetic and some plastics are there that are semi-synthetic. Okay, so that depend upon the arrangement. So see this slide. Plastic is also a polymer like a synthetic fiber, that we have learned that polymer means what? Long chain made up of small repeating unit. Same happen in a plastic. So plastic also have monomer, that single unit, and that we are arranging. But all plastics, they don't have same arrangement of unit. So you can see that the A and B. So in the first one, we can see that the four blocks are there, that blocks are actually monomer, okay, small single unit. They are arranged in a line, and that's why the arrangement is known as linear arrangement. And here, if you can observe that, see, the blocks are there, okay, linear, and in the parallel, vertical, like that. So that arrangement is known as cross link arrangement. Means see, this is a linear, this is a linear, but they are just connected to each other, so that arrangement is known as cross link arrangement. And because of this arrangement, the plastics are different in nature. Okay, now why are we using the plastic in more amount in many ways? So that because of the properties of these plastics. So one by one we will learn the properties of plastic. So first is that the plastic is easily moldable in all types of possible shapes. मोल्डेबल मीन्स वॉट? वी कैन चेंज शेप ऑफ द प्लास्टिक इन वॉट यू वॉन्ट. मीन्स इफ यू वॉन्ट सर्कुलर शेप यू कैन मोल्ड दैट प्लास्टिक, इफ यू वॉन्ट ट्रैंगुलर शेप, इफ यू वॉन्ट स्क्वेयर शेप. सो लाइक दैट वॉट एवर शेप यू वॉन्ट यू कैन जस्ट यूज दैट प्लास्टिक, यू कैन मोल्ड दैट प्लास्टिक एंड मेक द थिंग. नेक्स्ट वन, दैट प्लास्टिक कैन बी रिसाइकल्ड, कलर्ड, reused, rolled into sheets and made into wire. So because of the arrangement, because of the moldable property, we can use the plastic again. That process is known as recycling. Then plastic can be colored. Okay, that dyeing process is there. We can reuse the thing that made up of plastic. Okay, by applying pressure, we can convert the plastic into sheets or into wires, means we can make wires also from plastic. So these all the properties about the plastic, and the main property is that the plastic is easily moldable, means that can be shaped in any form, and that's why it finds such a variety of uses. Okay, so many examples are there. See, the plastic is used in making toys. Now you have toys, no? Now you are in 8th standard, but still some students are there. They are just again playing with the toys. So that toys are made up of plastic, suitcase, bags, cabinets, brush, chair, table, and many other countless items are there. So again, your one homework is that, homework means one activity is that, you have to write 10 things that made up of plastic which present in your surrounding. Okay, so this is one activity you have to do. So in the plastic, one example is there, that is polyethene. So see, poly plus ethene. So poly means many and ethene means a chemical substance. So when many ethene we are just joining together and form one polymer, that is known as polyethene, which is the most famous example of plastic which is used in manufacturing of carry bags. Now the carry bags that we are using, that is actually made up of polyethene bags. Okay, sorry, polyethene. So that names are polyethene bags. You know na, that black color or some white color transparent bags are there, that are actually polyethene bags. So see, many things that made up of plastic, that is chair, bucket, some containers are there, toys, see. So many things are there that we made from plastic. And because of that properties, that is moldable property, then recycling, reuse property, we can use the plastic to make many things. So in the plastic, like synthetic fibers, there are many types of synthetic fibers. So here also the types of plastic, but here are only two types of plastic. So first one is thermoplastic and next one is thermoset or thermosetting plastic. Okay, so one difference, one major difference in these two types of plastic, and because of that they are in different form. So first one, that is a thermoplastic. See, I have mentioned here difference, but first I will explain and then we will learn that. So first one is thermoplastic. See, can be melted repeatedly. Melted means what? By using heat, we can melt that plastic. Again, we can apply the pressure and just use that just batter or that thing to make many things. Okay, so thermoplastics are the plastic where shape can be altered by heating that object. Means if you have a plastic bottle, okay, that is a thermoplastic, by applying heat we can melt that bottle and just use that liquid to form another thing. So if the things are there, if the plastic is there that just change the shape after applying heat, are known as thermoplastic. Okay, thermoplastics are there, they just bend easily. Why they bend easily? Because they are very soft and weak. So that's why the thermoplastic are used to make toys and container. Means your whatever the toys are there, you just observe that they are very means lightweight, because they are soft and weak. And this thermoplastic can be recycled and reused. And this arrangement that we have learned that in this linear arrangement and cross-link arrangement, so the thermoplastics are actually applying the chain arrangement, means the linear arrangement, and that's why that can bend easily. So that is all about the thermoplastics. That opposite to that thermoplastic, thermosetting or thermostats are there. They cannot be altered by heating the object. Means once shaped, that cannot be melted. Means we cannot melt that plastic after applying heat. So they cannot be bent easily. They are very hard and strong. So that's why they are used for making the handles of cooking utensils. We know that if the pan is there, so that circular shape is made up of metal and the handle is made up of plastic. And that plastic is actually a thermosetting plastic. When the metal is started to heat, they are passing the heat to that plastic, that handle. But because of the thermosetting plastic, the handles cannot be bent, cannot be melt. Okay? And because of this property, the thermosetting plastic cannot be reused again. And they are in 3D arrangement. You know, now the 3D structure is there. So like that, the arrangement of thermosetting is in 3D nature. So that's why they are opposite to each other. So I have mentioned here the difference between the thermoplastic and thermosetting. So just remember one thing in your mind, that thermoplastic means what? If we are applying heat, they just change their shape. And thermosetting means what? If we are applying heating, they cannot be softened, they cannot be changed, their shape are known as thermosetting. So see the first point, that difference between the thermoplastic and thermosetting. Don't confuse. A small thing is there, you have to just keep in your mind so you can understand the difference between these two. So thermoplastic, which gets deformed easily. Deform means they can change their shape on heating and can be bent easily, are known as thermoplastics. And opposite to that, plastics which when molded once, if we apply the pressure and if we mold that plastic, again that cannot be softened by heating. Means again and again we cannot change the shape of this plastic, that are known as thermosetting plastic. Then some examples are there of thermoplastic, like polythene, that we know that bag is there. That is polythene and PVC. PVC means polyvinyl chloride. So these are some examples of thermoplastic. Then thermosetting examples like bakelite and melamine. Okay, so bakelite and melamine are the examples of thermosetting plastics. Then the use of these both, that thermoplastic are used for manufacturing toys, combs and various types of containers. And opposite to that, bakelite, which is the example of thermosetting, is used for making electrical switches, handles of various utensils. And the melamine is used for making floor tiles, kitchenware and fabrics which resist fire. Okay, so I hope that you are not confused between the thermoplastic and thermosetting. Okay, the various easy points are there, you can understand. Okay, so in this session we have learned about the plastic, means what is a plastic. So plastic is also a polymer, like a synthetic fiber. Okay, they just form by linear arrangement and cross-link arrangement. All plastic do not have same arrangement. Then we have learned some properties of plastic, that they are easily moldable. They can be recycled, colored, reused and rolled into sheets and made into wires. Then we have learned that which things are made up of plastics, like toys, bags, tables, carry bags, brush and many things are there. Okay, then we have learned the two types of plastic, that is thermoplastic and thermosetting or thermosets. Okay, see, the thermoplastic means that shape can be altered by heating that object. Opposite to that, thermosetting plastic that cannot be altered by heating the object. Thermoplastic bent easily, thermosetting cannot be bent easily. Thermoplastic are very soft and weak. Thermosetting are hard and strong. Thermoplastic used to make toys and container, and thermosetting are used to make handles of cooking utensils. Thermoplastic can be recycled and reused, but thermosetting cannot be reused and means we cannot reuse again. Examples of thermoplastic, that is PVC, polythene, PS, that is polystyrene, PE, polyethylene, PP, that is polypropylene. And the examples of thermosetting are melamine and polyester. Then arrangement of thermoplastic is in chain arrangement, and in thermosetting the arrangement is in 3D nature. So I hope that you have understand the difference between the thermoplastic and thermosetting. Just one point remember, that is which one is change shape after heating and which one cannot. Okay, so thermoplastic change the shape after heating, thermosetting cannot change the shape. So see some examples, that articles made by thermosetting. Thermosetting means what? They are not melting. Okay, see the example, that handle, electrical switches, some plates are there. Okay, then the articles made of thermoplastic. See the container and some toys, some wires. Okay, so all these about the types of plastic and the introduction part of plastic. So I hope that you have understand about the plastic and the types of plastic. Still, if you have any doubt, you can ask in comment box. Do your homework that I have mentioned, that I have told, that you have to write the 10 things that made up of plastic. Okay, thank you.